There was once an old woman named Agnes Jones. Due to a strange, crippling disease that turned her legs to blackened rags, Agnes had spent her entire life confined to a hospital bed. For 83 years she lay, listening to the tick of the clock and the shuffling of the hall outside. She had no friends, no family, no company, no pastime. She might as well have been dead, but for the nurses and their medicine. This stifling existence afforded no pleasure to Agnes, save for her secret indulgence in a disgusting childhood habit. Whenever there weren't any nurses about, Agnes, with a long, withered finger, would pick her nose and flick its crispy contents from where she lay in her bed into the old, unused broom closet on the other side of the room.
"Who looks in there anyhow?"
she reasoned.
"And after all, it's only for my comfort. What else am I to do?"
And so, Agnes powdered up her wailing conscience and continued day by day to pick her nose whenever she found herself alone. Until one night, just before dawn, a young nurse with soft, silent feet came to check on the old woman.
I was only itching the inside right when you walked in. Don't look at me like that. Even if I was doing what you think I was doing, could you blame me? If you were locked in a dingy old ward, you would do that. By which I mean whatever you think I was doing. I, for one, haven't the slightest idea what you think I was doing, so you can just go away and leave me alone.
The young nurse turned her delicate face to the closet. Although Agnes had discarded her mucus into it every day for 83 years, there was no sign of her mischief to be seen, for an unearthly shadow rested within, concealing all but the very threshold from sight.
When I was a little girl, my mother told me never to pick my nose. She said that if I continued to do so, that one day a horrible, horrible thing would come and...
And what, child?
And gobble me up.
Rubbish and fairy tales. Besides, I was doing nothing of the kind, so there's really no more to say.
Even so, I will pray for you.
The pretty, prissy princess! Her whole perfect little fairy tale life ahead of her. And she comes in here to judge me and tell me how to live my life. Why?
And with that, Agnes bitterly threw her finger into her nostril and wrenched forth a ghastly stretch of snot. For a moment, she held it above her head and let it dangle before her eyes like a sling of crusty dough.
"Forgive me my mortal sin," she said,
and hurled the abomination into the closet. Oh dear, what a shame.